purpose is me. About to tackle the world's greatest marathon spanning 90 kilometers from Pietermaritzburg to Durban. How I got to this point, we first have to rewind just a tad.
Final checks, final pack. Sunglasses. Never leave home without them. Right, got through security at the boarding gate. Can relax and enjoy the trip. Few logistics. Pack light. You want to make sure that you have everything that can go in the cabin regulation size bag. You don't want to put anything on the hold, even wear the running shoes. Be pleased that you did. Last time to travel. Well, just after three. That took about 5 hours. But we're here. It's Comrades Weekend. Expo time. Right, after a slight deviation of a room change, I was initially given a room that smelled like somebody had set a tobacco factory on fire. We're off to the expo. First have to say, kudos to UCD Lodge. Swapped me around and gave me a new room. Feels great. Right, going to the expo. Now, the expo is just one part of the whole Comrades experience. You go there, you get the vibe, collect your race pack, get your race number, and of course, got timing chip on it as well, which is going to give you a final result. But it's more than just that. It's about really feeling part of it. You're looking at the exhibitors, you know, meeting up with other fellow runners, you know, just picking up what it's all about. It's a fantastic experience. I'm going to show you around. Green number. A privilege awarded to those who've completed at least 10. This year, I'm a number 5. 5 more years to go. We'll see if I make it. Comrades is a race steeped in history, as you can see. Something that draws thousands of people every year. I'm one of them. There you have it, Comrades 2022. Pretty much a one-stop shop. Food, clothing, shoes, socks, supplements, physio, you name it, you can get it. They say nothing new on race day. Always a good idea to keep to that. Expo, done and dusted. Right, it's probably worthwhile just explaining a little bit of the context of all of this. I'm here to run the 2022 Comrades Marathon. Happens to be the 95th, happens to be my 5th, which is great. But how did I get here? How do the logistics work? In my particular case, I've chosen to do a travel package. Some people stay with family, some people partner up with friends. If you're traveling on your own, which is what I'm doing in this particular case, it's far easier logistically just to take on a travel package. There are companies that do it. I've signed up with one. And they arrange pretty much everything from your flights, your airport transfers, your accommodation, and so on. So in my case, they arrange my flight from Cape Town through to Durban. They pick us up at the airport. They shuttle us through to the hotel where I am now. You're close enough to the expo so you can just walk. After that, you spend the night here. Tomorrow lunchtime, you then get shuttled through to Pietermaritzburg and where you then stay the night. They will then bring your luggage back for you from Pietermaritzburg back to Durban, which is very convenient, while you find your way home on foot, hopefully. You then get picked up at the Moses Mabhida Stadium, which is where the finish is. You get shuttled back to your hotel, You then spend the night, which in this case is this hotel again. And then the next morning, being the Monday morning, you then travel through to the airport and you catch your return flight home, hopefully with the Comrades medal around your neck. So that's the plan. Right now, dinner time.
Right, I'm down here, down in North Beach, just seeing if I can kind of find a little bit more of that Comrades Chariots. And I think I've just found it.
Are you the skilled gentleman that does it? Wowza!
Finish there in the background. Right, just a quick history lesson. The very first Comrades Marathon was run on the 24th of May 1921. It was the brainchild of Vic Clapham, a war veteran, and he wanted something that could be a memorial to the fallen soldiers of the war. It's been run every year since, with the exception of taking a break during World War II, as well as the most recent COVID-19 pandemic. And to date, more than 300,000 people have actually participated in it. And the idea is to celebrate mankind's spirit of overcoming adversity.
Right, we're in Pietermaritzburg now. It is T-minus 11 hours and counting until gun goes off. Got things to get ready, put the race number on, set race kit out, make sure everything is ready and in place. You don't want any surprises for early hours of the morning, because the alarm goes off at 2 a.m. Bus leaves at 4 to get to the start, so you need to be ready. Let's go. Right, 2 a.m. Day starting. This is it. Right, 5 minutes past 3. Just going to have some breakfast. The thing that you have to watch out for is you don't leave everything to the last minute. Now, fortunately, this place, they're actually really good. They go and they set up breakfast at 3 a.m. Right, just got off the bus on our way to the start, but just got to go do the tog bag drop. So I've got a few things we're waiting in Durban at the finish, and then off to the seeding pens. It is now 4:24, so time is getting close. Right, in our seeding pen, now we wait, catch a vibe.
Yeah. past the route marker that said 86 kilometers to go. Got a sea of runners ahead and a sea of runners behind. Just reminds you how many people tackled this incredible race.
Right, 45 minutes in, hitting my first water point. Probably time to get a bit of a refill.
Any words of wisdom?
What?
Any words of wisdom?
Any words of wisdom? Jou kop moet hou, en dan moet jou lyf hou, en jy moet eet en drink. Dis al.
And that is good advice.
It starts in the mind.
Sun just starting to come up. Hopefully not going to be too much of a scorcher of a day. Time will tell. We do know though, Durban is always a warmer finish. So we'll see how it goes. It's 6:58 a.m. 78 kilometer mark. Feeling good. Right, approaching the first cutoff. The cutoffs, which there are a few, are in place with time limits. In order to kind of secure those that pass those points at particular points in time, or before particular points in time, are likely to make it to the finish. This is the first one. Cutoffs, while very popular, can also be places for great disappointment and pain, especially if you have to board the Baylor's bus. It's a place you want to avoid. But we're good so far. Nutrition. Important to keep it up. Need all the energy you can get. Especially when you've still got 3/4 of the race ahead of you. Days are early. Lunch time. Looking like a little bit of echo to get the runners going. Thank you. Banana. Thank you. Banana time. There's some interesting stats getting that banana back there. This year, there's 1.9 million sachets of water. There's 9 tons of oranges, 4.5 tons of potatoes, over 30,000 litres of Coke, 45,000 litres of Fanta and cream soda, not to mention the ice of it, which is a electrolyte drink on offer, amongst other things. Potatoes and oranges still to come though. Potatoes good for carbo loading, especially with a bit of salt added. It's a bit later in the race, so. For now, happy with banana. Good up, comrades, for always being well prepared. Maybe now's a good time to talk about race strategy. An event like this, you have to go in with a race strategy. Rule number one, know your ability. There's no point in busting your race in the first half. I need to find that you crash and burn after that point. Steady and slow is normally key. Get a timing chart, pace yourself, know how you should be running from your training, and stick to it. For me, that usually includes a run-walk strategy. Most people will do that. The difference is you actually want to finish the event and enjoy it, rather than regret it, either through overheating, dehydration, cramping, and so on. So you got to watch out for those key factors as well. That's all part of your race strategy. Know when to hydrate, know when to take an electrolyte, know when to eat, read your body. That's where the experience comes in. And if you do that, you don't need to suffer. Yeah, sure, your legs will be sore at times, and you're going to feel tired, but that's part of it. That's part of the experience. Don't let that deter you. Go in, finish strong. That's key. To the finish. Welcome to Camperdown. Can't tell the vibe. People just come out on their masses. Can I play music? Set up the squattles. Just encourage everyone on the road. Really incredible. That's what makes this race so special. And I think it still draws a lot of people back every year. Every year.
Faster to run.
You're coming to Durban. Hey! You're faster than most of us. Second cup of bed. Now for some technical info. The race is timed gun to mat, meaning when the gun goes up at the start, the clock starts ticking, irrespective of where you are in the start field. But the question is, how do they actually time that? Historically, there were timing chips on the shoe. They use a technology called RFID, stands for radio frequency identification. And on every bib, you will see a timing chip. What does the timing chip look like? Just like this. How it actually works on radio waves. What happens is, as you pass each checkpoint, there are some antenna or RF panels that are up, the white square looking things, and they are transmitting. And these chips receive that signal and they do what's called backscatter. And based on the identification, because each chip has got a unique identifier, which is linked to each runner profile, they then know who passed at what point. So when you cross the finish line, that's how you get your actual time. And as you cross each cutoff point, that's how you go about and you get your sector time for each cutoff point. Just a bit of interesting info. Traffic to Durban. Sometimes it's just quicker to run.
Yes. There's been some development, especially in this area.
Really?
Yeah. What sort of development? There could be a lot of like junk, you know?
Oh, I see.
Yeah. A lot of those other people. There's danger of place. People who are staying around here.
Right. Mentally one marathon done. Let's start the next. Arthur Seat. Legend has it Arthur Newton would take a seat there and rest during his long runs. And if you greet Arthur, how's it Arthur? You have a good second half. Let's hope to that.
Comrades, Hall of Fame.
There's some 30 to go. No, it didn't go back to Peter Maritzburg, that's for sure. That is one very welcome sight. Here we go, baby! Time to be a crusader. Share the others home. And that is a wrap of Comrades 2022.
Running a Comrades is truly a unique and remarkable experience that is something that words are hard to describe. I do acknowledge it's not for everyone. Some people will love it, some people will hate it. Some people have a good day, some people have a bad day. For me, it was 11 hours on the road for essentially 1 minute worth of euphoria when you enter the stadium, you see the people, you hear them cheering, and you know you've made it. You're on that green carpet, and you've got a few hundred meters to go, and you've conquered it. It's something I'll always treasure. It's something I'll always remember. And that was actually the reason why I wanted to make this video. I wanted to share that experience. Some people will never run it, and that's completely fine. Some people might be inspired to run it, and that's fine too. At the end of the day, it's a very personal experience. In the training that you have to put in to get to this point, no, very, very few people could ever just simply wake up one day with zero training and decide that they could conquer a Comrades. The average mortal, like myself, it's months. In this case, almost 9 months worth of training. And things can go right and things can go wrong on the day. Today, there were things that went wrong. There was a lot I got right, and there were certainly things that I got wrong. But you live and learn. At the end of the day, it doesn't matter what anybody says, a finish is a finish. If you get the medal, you've earned it. And of course, it is heartbreaking when you see those who've put in the same amount of effort or more and get denied it by a few seconds. But I guess that's life. I would like to thank Comrades for everything that they put into it. It's truly a remarkable event. I'd love to thank the people of KwaZulu-Natal who come out in their masses, who support, not only in cheering, but they also go ahead and they make provision. For now, back to Cape Town tomorrow. It's been good. Until next time, maybe.